Hazai, goedemiddag allemaal. En welkom voor even vandaag zijn Live at 5 op jullie 18e mei. Dat is de 53ste dag van ons lockdown. Ik hoop het gaan goed met jullie allemaal. En geef het zo om een kans voor mensen om in te schakelen. Ik hoop jullie een lekker kopje koffie. En dat jullie allemaal gemakkelijk is en rustig en veilig is. Ik is zo om een laat, moet ik gaan mijn setup veranderen. Omdat het zo vannacht donker raak die staal, is het toch al aan die andere kant van die huis baie donker. So ek sit vandag bietjie aan die agterkant van die tuin. Goeiemiddag Terry, lekker om jou te sien. Hallo Mersha, Elsabie, goeiemiddag allemaal. Chantal Bloem, goeiemiddag. Sarel, goed om jou te sien, welkom. Sien nou vir die inskakel. Hallo Joe, hallo Johan, potgedraai, Tanine, lekker om te sien. Tanine Duwani, welkom, goeiemiddag. Lekker om te sien. En hallo Marty, ook uit Tanine, goeiemiddag. En omdaan Tanine Joey. Hallo Jim, lekker om te sien weer, en middag Lorette, geluk met die dochterkie wat julle, jy word ouma van die dochterkie hoor ek, en David Dreyer, middag, Heidi Trollop, hallo, ja, Joe nogmaals, en ek hoop het gaan goed met julle allemaal. Middag Louis, Kreer ook in die ligmag, Jakob Becker, hallo Sarel, en Tanerete om Adrien, goed om julle te sien, hallo Elise, lekker om julle te sien, Stefan. Hallo, goed om jou weer te sien. Hallo Linda, sien jullie allemaal voor die inskakeling so ver. Ons gesoek oomlik die middag Atti. William daar uit Rustenburg. Goed om te sien. Middag te Loris, goed om te sien daar uit Nigel uit. Ja, hallo Frans. Om Frans, hallo Kiewit. Goed om te sien, geseënde dag. Hallo Henny. Sien jullie soos jullie inskakel. Ek hoop het gaan goed met jullie allemaal. Hallo Anne, goed om te sien ook daar uit Mokopane uit. En Annelien, Louis strijd om daar die Westkaap. Hallo Henny. Middag Chrissy van de Westhuizen, lekker om jou te sien, en sien julle soos julle inskakel, ons sien ons so 2 of 3 minuten, dat ons mense kans gee om in te log, op hierdie maandag, die 18e mei, en hoop het gaan goed met julle allemaal, dat allemaal gezond is, en voorspoedig is. Middag Cindy van Deventer, Ola, goed om jou te sien. Middag Monica, lekker om jou te sien, en Jan van Deventer, goeiemiddag. Hey Leon, ook daar ik mok op aan, het goed om te sien. Ik hoop het gaan goed met jullie allemaal daar, hallo Gina. En ja, die winter is, soos jy kan sien, in die aand liggie gaga op ons. En ek sit hier in die achterkant van my tuin, omdat het juist te vinnig donker word aan die voorkant. En as hy jou oe uitvee, dan is het nogal donker. So hierdie kant hoop ek gaan het een bietjie langer licht wees. Middag, hi Benny, how are you out of Denmark? Good to see you Benny, hallo Louis, hallo Marijke, goed om jou te sien. Good to see you, Henku, welkom vir die inskakel. Hello, Karel, welcome, welcome, bless you for tuning in. Benny, I hope you guys are doing well in Denmark, and that you are blessed and healthy, and yeah, everybody going well, in Elisa as well. Praise God, praise die Here. Lekker om so te wees saam met julle hierdie tyd van die dag. Hey, Stefan uit Senekal, my wereldpaas, Stefan, goed om jou te sien. Ek hoop het gaan goed met julle daar, hallo Gerard en Petro, lekker om julle te sien, bless julle vir die inskakel. It's really good to have you with us this afternoon. Hallo Adrie, lekker om te sien, ek hoop het gaan goed met Moemp, en dat julle allemaal gezond is, en ja, die Here so goedheid oor julle beleef. Thank you God, well, just giving a moment for everybody to tune in, and then we'll dive right into the word for this afternoon, van ons inspring, en wat ek voel op my hart vir hierdie middag en hierdie week. Hallo Alet, lekker om jou te sien. Gooi vir jouself 'n lekker koppie koffie, get yourself a nice cup of coffee, and we're going to spend a wonderful time together. Trinet, hallo, lekker om te sien. Hey Fanny, goed om jou te sien. Goeiemiddag, hallo Shiloh, good to see you out of Polokwane. Hallo Vira, goed om te sien, en we hoop het gaan goed met julle allemaal. Ek sien Shiloh, jou dochter is gestrand daar op 'n boot, en ons dink saam aan julle, een van die, ek weet nie, het is YWAM's boot as ek te verkeerd is, nee, maar ja, stuur vir ons een bykie een link om bykie te volg die informatie, Shiloh. Hallo Kornei, lekker om jou te sien, goeiemiddag. Dit is eindelijk een prentje wat jy daar opgooi. En ek hoop het gaan goed met julle allemaal, weens soos ek gesê het, vandag die 18e mei, 53ste dag, 53rd day, middag soos ek welkom. Hallo Rochelle, goed om jou te sien, bless you guys for tuning in. We're giving a few moments, I know some guys just have to quickly get off work and make it, I just want to give them an opportunity to log in. Oftentimes people write me and say, well, they just missed it because of the time, and I was in too much of a hurry to finish, and they were just starting to log on, and then we were off again. So I'm sitting on the other side of the house today because of the light, vir die lig, dan is het net 'n bietjie langer, die son sak aan hierdie kant. Dan is het een beetje langer licht. Aan de andere kant is die schaduw weer baie vinnig op ons de shade. On the other side is very quickly. Oh, oké, okay, OM se boot. Oké, okay, dank je Johan. OM se boot. Dis reg, dit was OM nie. Waar my OM se boot, ja. Ja. So, ons het, ek sien al so 'n donate knopje op die Facebook site. As die ouens wat vir die mense van OM, there's some guys of OM that have been quarantined on a boat and they're really dependent on people helping them. So if you see them on Facebook, I think they're asking $100, please help them. Hallo Rina van Ham, hallo Barry, hallo Tini Jen, goed om jou te sien, goeiemiddag. And it's really good to be with you, lekker om saam met julle te wees in hierdie middag. Wel, ons gaan reguit begin induik in die woord en miskien net so voor ons te doen, just before we do that, we've been doing the Live at 5 for basically 7 weeks now. Which is, we've been really blessed to have the time together in the afternoons. Ons was geseend geweest om die tijd in die middag te hê. But we have to be also wise in terms of our timing. Hulle dan die genie, hoop ek gaan goed daar by julle weergens. Goed om jou te sien op die lugmag. Welcome, bless you guys for tuning in. We have to also be very wise. Ons moet ook wijs wees. En graag wil ons dit doen wat mense meer bedien. En julle moet asseblief my laat weet. Gooi som op een comment of so aan. Wat soort tye vir julle beter is. Which times are better. We will be bringing out very soon a morning devotion. Which will be a 5-minute on your WhatsApp devotion. 3 to 5 minutes. Just a short devotion to help start the day, to kickstart the morning, and to kickstart your prayer life and your day with Jesus. So, hello Clarissa, bless you for the inskakel and lekker om jou saam met ons te hê. Good to have you with us and bless you for tuning in. So we are considering to move it over into that because we will be going to lockdown level 3 soon, which means more people will be at work, which means more people will be unavailable at 5 o'clock. So maybe we should move the time to 5:30. In the evenings or so, and then only have it 2 or 3 times a week because we are having cell at basically 6 upper 6 at goeiemiddag Henriette, lekker om julle te sien uit Polokwane. We will be having cell at basically upper 6 actually in Nutrigard. You have to start watching your videos so that at 7 o'clock we can start with the cell on Zoom. And also we have some other meetings on at Zoom as well. We have the Polokwane cell also on at 7 on Thursday night. So that would mean we'd have to look, ons moet begin kyk na miskien 'n 5:30, 5:30 slot as more people will be starting to work at during the level 3 lockdown that we are moving to. And then it wouldn't be a good idea to just go on at 5. Most people will then still be at work and could not slot in. Or maybe the morning devotion that we will be sending out. We will be starting with that shortly in the next few days. We should be starting with that 5-minute early morning devotion to have that 3 to 5 minutes. Just start the day with God. Start the day with an encouraging word, a faith confession, a prayer in the Lord to kickstart the day in faith. That's part of what we are planning to do. We are working on that. And we just want to get all our ducks in a row before we just kick a thing off because you have to maintain it. You will it can follow and it's our heart not just to start something and not keep encouraging people. We want to build on what we are starting. Hello Judy, goed om jou te sien and bless you for the inskakeling. So this weekend or yesterday we spoke about the outpouring of the Holy Spirit from the book of Acts. And we were looking at Acts chapter 2 and the promise that Jesus gave in Luke 24 about the Holy Spirit. There's 9 different places in the Gospels that Jesus spoke about the promised Holy Spirit, the uitstorting van die Heilige Geest. And I believe we are heading for a mighty, mighty outpouring of the Spirit of God. A mighty move of God amongst the kingdom of God and the church and the people of the Lord. Die mense van die Here. Ons maak gereed nie net vir herlewing. You see, when we speak about revival, herlewing, wil ek graag reg definieer. Herlewing is wanneer Christene wat in 'n teruggevalle staat lewe, en miskien in 'n lewenstyl geval het wat ongesond is. A revival is where Christians have become lukewarm. Middag Jaapie, middag Basil, middag Trudy, bless julle vir julle inskakeling, bless you guys for tuning in. Herlewing is waar Christene wat teruggeval het en miskien in hulle verhouding met die Here gestagneer het, hulle word geherleef. A revival is when Christians actually get shaken up. The Church of Jesus might have fallen into a place of apathy and into a place where they have become lukewarm, and so the Spirit of God comes and quickens the body of Jesus Christ, quickens the church, and in the church a move of God starts to happen. Middag Shemaine, bless you for the inskakel. A move of God starts amongst believers, and that then spills over into a group of believers, into the church, like we see with Bethel happening, and we saw that with Hillsongs, and we saw it with a couple of movements around the world where the Spirit of God quickens a body of believers, and they start to become revived, and the worship starts to change, and the preaching starts to change, and it becomes very passionate for God. And most of that touches the church. Baie daarvan raak die kerk aan, and that's really awesome and it's really important. And that's what Acts speaks about in the book of Acts. As julle handeling hulle saam met my lees. In the book of Acts it says in verse chapter 3 verse 18, it says God was besig om te laat gebeur wat al die profete vroeger oor die Messias aangekondig het, dat hy sou lei, kom tot inkeer en maak reg met God, zodat julle sonde uitgevee kan word. Dan sal die teenwoordigheid van die Here tye van opleving tot gevolg hê en hy sal Jesus julle Messias weer na julle stuur. And it speaks about times of refreshing coming from the presence of God. Goeiemiddag Louise van der Linde, lekker om jou te sien. The times of refreshing will come from the presence of God. And normally that refreshing is a refreshing of believers. Normally when that happens, the Spirit of God is poured out on believers and they become passionate again. Their hearts are set on fire. The Lord does a mighty work amongst believers and it spills over into the churches and into communities and great work starts to manifest. And it's a bonatuurlijke werk. You see, this is a supernatural work. It's not something that believers stir themselves up by faith. It is a working from the Holy Spirit. Dit is een werk van die Heilige Gees in die harte van gelowiges. Ek is jammer as ek vandag een bietjie meer Engels praat. Ek wil graag mense wat van die buitenland af inskakel, wanneer hulle op hierdie geleenthede inskakel, akkommodeer. So vergeef my as ek so probeer tweetalig wees, ek probeer net akkommodeer vooral vir van ons broers in die Here Jesus en familie. Broers en sisters wat nie heeltemal Afrikaans magtig is nie, of glad nie Afrikaans magtig is nie. En dan sal ek het so tweetalig gooi, as het een probleem raak, gooi vir my net, gooi een bietjie meer Afrikaans, en dan sal ek om switch. So what happens here is that the Bible says clearly that times of refreshing will come from the presence of God when people turn to Christ, turn to the Lord. But revival is one segment of what I believe God wants to do. You see, during an outpouring or an awakening of a uitstorting of a verfrissing of a manifestatie van die geest van die Here, it's also a supernatural work. But what happens is the unsaved world is impacted by an outpouring of God. And these are major events. Dis baie spesifieke gebeurtenisse waar die wêreld geskud word. The world is even shaken by the outpouring of what God does. The moral fiber of nations starts to change. People are impacted by the love of Jesus Christ. And it goes much broader than a single group of churches or church. It goes and it impacts unbelievers. I remember when the Welsh revival was happening and the people got saved. Die mense was by die duisende gered. And some of these guys were really bad guys. They were really drunkards. They were really guys who were rough in their way. They spoke really bad. Hulle het nie soos ons gepraat gesê, praise die Here, loof die Here, het gevloek en geknoop, jong. Hallo Frederik, lekker om jou te sien, welkom vir die inskakeling. And they were really rough diamonds and rough guys. And so what happens is, the Spirit of God was poured out in the Welsh revival, and it spilled over the nations. It actually started with John Wesley, and it started and then it kicked fire the whole revival in America. That started in the UK, kicked over, spilled over into the US, and it actually ran throughout the West. A mighty move of God was happening, and the guys working in the mines got saved and born again, and hulle lewe het so radikaal verander that they had to change. And ons is nou hiervan praat, vir ons klink het min, but they had 2,000 to 5,000 donkeys working on the mines, pulling out the carts of all the coal and raw materials, that they couldn't work with these pack animals anymore, because the pack animals could not respond to them because they stopped swearing. They understood the swearing as the instructions what to do. And it was so, the impact was so great that the mining companies had to change the pack animals because they didn't know how to respond. and hulle was nie meer geslaat en geabused nie, because these guys got saved and born again, and this revival had started in a small church in the UK with 5 people in attendance after the service that became an intercession event that shook the heart of the nation, wat mense van die straat af ingestroom het en het op hulle knie voor die Here geval het, and it was the same in the Falklands revival, or the outpouring of the Spirit on the Falklands. En as ons daar oor praat, ek wil graag ons 'n prentjie gee, so dat ons geloof kan uitsit en kan ontvang wat die Here wil doen. God wants to do a mighty work in our day. And we are, as a church, in this season of separation to seek God and to use this time wisely. And yes, what the enemy wanted to use or wants to use to destroy, to bring frustration. En dis een van die grootste uitdagings in hierdie tyd is frustrasie. Ek weet, ons ondervind het soms onself, dat ou voel, jy weet, you just can't function normally. Die skoolwerk voel of het jou oorweldig en het voel so of jy net nie jou voete vind nie. But that's a strategy of the enemy to cause us to take our eyes off from God and to put our eyes on our circumstance, to put our eyes on the difficulties that people are going through, to put our eyes on below the sun. Jy weet, Salomo skryf, toe ek my oë bo die son gehou het en die heerlikheid van God gesien het, toe was die wêreld mooi. But as soon as hy so dra sy oë onder die son gesak het en hy hier na die aarde begin kyk het, toe sê hy, dit is alles, in Engelse woord is dit beter, meaningless. Ek weet nie of Afrikaanse woord is vir meaningless nie. Goeiemiddag Esme Prins, hoe lekker om jou te sien. And so God is preparing the church. God is shaking us a bit. And he's using what the enemy wanted to use to destroy us. He's using to our benefit. Rick Joyner said something very powerful many years ago. While I was in the US with them, he spoke about God never wasting a hurt. And he ministered from the book of, I think it was Colossians, the Apostle Paul, that says, from the comfort I have received, I have comforted you. And he said, spoke that Paul went through many woundings and many hurts and much pain. And from that came actually, instead of Paul being destroyed, Paul became strong. And from that came a ministry that healed so many others. And God used the weaknesses in Paul's life that seemed to him, nutteloos is die woord, dankie Rosemary, dit is 'n goeie woord, dat Salomo sê, alles is nutteloos, ja, dit is 'n goeie woord. That God used the wounding and the hurts of the past, the stuff that happened, to raise up a ministry, to raise up a man that could speak into other people's lives and bring healing into very painful and difficult situations. And so I believe that we are in this situation, and the enemy wants to harm God's kingdom, and he wants to harm you as a believer. He wants to use this to separate you, to attack you. He wants to use this to separate you, to get your focus off from God, to have you fall into depression and darkness. But the Lord is using this so that we start to hunger, and as we turn our eyes to God, soos ons harte na die Here draai, there's a season of refreshing coming. There's a season of a mighty outpouring of the Holy Spirit at hand, and as a body we have to prepare for that. And I've been working through this, and I've been studying the word, and I've also, you know, through many years we have studied many revivals and awakenings, and since the late the middle 1700s there was 150 outpourings of the Holy Spirit, not per se revivals, 150 outpourings of the Holy Spirit. There were many revivals, but an outpouring of the Spirit is where there's a supernatural work of God that comes and affects change within a body of people and within a nation, within a country and a world. En ek glo ons is besig om gereed te maak daarvoor. I believe we are preparing for that. I believe that the Lord, even as we prepare for Pentecost, is going to surprise us. Many people watched the Salt Lake Revival with Todd Bentley, and we all know that there was a lot of stuff that didn't go totally right. But you know, Todd Bentley and his ministry led a lot of people to Jesus in that time. And oftentimes we take our focus off from what God is doing, and it goes on to man. And I believe that the Lord is preparing the church for the greatest harvest, the harvest at the end of the age, the greatest harvest of all, where the kingdom of God will manifest. And soos in die droom van Daniel, van hierdie standbeeld wat staan, en is 'n groot standbeeld, en Nebukadnezar was die kop, en regdeur tot by die voete was van goud gewees, en die voete was yster en klei, en toe kom hierdie klein klippie, wat die koninkryk van die Here is, en het vernietig hierdie standbeeld. And it spoke about the kingdoms of the earth, that the dispensations of the kingdoms of men, or the kingdoms of the world, will be destroyed, and there will be a mighty, mighty demonstration of the kingdom of God. That God's kingdom will come and manifest, and it says, and of his rule and reign there will never be an end. And we will be participating with God. Ek en jy gaan samenwerkers met die Here wees. We will see a mighty work of God in our day and in our time. And so we need to prepare our hearts for that. I believe the Lord is busy putting his church in a place where they hunger and thirst again. Because when we gather, there's a place where the Lord Jesus manifests himself. It says that about worship. That said it from worship. When we come together, we become a place where the Lord dwells through the Spirit. And as we are preparing our hearts to again start gathering together, I believe that God is going to pour His Spirit out in a mighty way upon the people of South Africa, the Church of Jesus, and the body of Christ across the world. But the impact of that will even be in the streets, and the sinners will get saved upon the mighty move of God. And the prophets will truly prophesy. The apostles will truly lead the church. And I believe that in this season where we had to almost withdraw ourselves, that the Lord wants us to just align with his heart and with his purposes again. And the prophets will be prophets in the fullness of the calling and purpose of Jesus Christ for them and for us. And the apostles will move into the apostolic office, the correct office, not because of the fame and not because of the position, but because of what God is doing to fully serve the Lord. The evangelistic move of God, where the true evangelists will move in the fire of the Holy Spirit, and the great harvest will be brought in. I believe that the Lord has withdrawn us to a secret place to seek Him, to be filled with Him again. As we prepare for Pentecost, for there's a mighty outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon this land ahead. It's in this next season. And so prepare your hearts. Get ready. Get yourself prepared, you know, get your spirit in order, get your house in order, deal with the stuff you got to deal, get the pornography out and get the lies and the wrong books and the wrong stuff out of your life, deal with the stuff you need to deal with, and it's a time for us to really get ready. You know, to get ready before you go on a camping trip, you don't just say today, yay, here we go. No, you have to pack a lot of stuff. And I believe God wants to use you and me in a mighty way in this coming season, that we will live in the fullness of the calling and the purpose of Jesus Christ for this day. Otherwise, we are wasting the time. We are wasting time by being stuck with so much nonsense. And, you know, it's so easy to get caught up in all the schoolwork. It's so easy to get caught up. And then this minister is saying that. And then that minister is saying that. And this one gets a kickback from the cigarettes. And that one gets a kickback from selling blankets. And this one gets no kickback because KFC is closed. And that's all nonsense. And I believe we should just keep our eyes on the right goal. And as believers, the right goal is to prepare for the end of days, the mighty harvest of God, the greatest harvest that the world has ever seen is at hand. And I spoke to a few weeks ago from Hebrews 11, chapter 40, that God said He has kept the best for this time, that them together, all the guys that has gone before us, with us, will see the fulfillment of the promise of God. And I believe that we have seen many great revivalists, many great outpourings of the Spirit in history. As I said, I've been studying them for the last few weeks, and I see from 1730 up to today, there's been 150 specific outpourings of the Holy Spirit that's recorded. Even up to the Brown Revival or the Brownsville outpouring in the 90s to 2000. And I believe that the Lord is preparing the body of Jesus Christ for a mighty move of the Spirit. And with that will come the full recognition to the offices that God has given the church. And I believe that much of what has been prophesied, much of what has been said, much of what God has said for this nation and for the nations of the world will become prevalent as we step into the season ahead. So here's what I want to encourage you to do. As it says here in the book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 20, the times of refreshing will come from the presence of God. But it starts with this: repent and turn to God. And I believe we need to just again focus back, get our eyes back on the Lord Jesus. It is so easy to get captive by our circumstance. It's so easy, you know, today was such a full day for me. I just was from hither to thither, here and there, and this and that. And in the end, you get so occupied. And I deal with people, and in the end, you need to watch your heart. Otherwise, you become discouraged. Everybody feels so depressive and discouraged. And, oh no, how long will it still be? And how long will that? And what about this? And did you? And I want to encourage you. Sometimes, you know, separation means to also maybe stop watching the media a little bit. Maybe don't listen to everything in the news. There's been so much speculation about the school. I don't want to hear it anymore. I believe we need to get our focus in order. We are preparing for a mighty work of God. We are preparing for a mighty move of the Spirit, unlike what many people have ever seen. I don't believe that anybody has seen what is yet to come. You know, when we look at the book of Revelation, we see the prophetic and the office of the prophet in the book of Revelation moving in such a place of power that at the words of the mouths of the prophet, the enemies get destroyed. There's such gifting and power available in Jesus Christ that no one has ever thought of or imagined that. And I believe the Lord is preparing the church and you and me. He's preparing and calling us. And so this week, we'll be speaking about the outpourings of God, looking at maybe one or two from the past, but then looking on what God has for us, looking on what the Word says, the future says. And we have not seen an army like the book of Joel has spoken about, where God's people are like an army of locusts that covers the land, that will take possession of the promises. And we have the promise of God, but it's time to possess it. It's time that the nation of South Africa and the world experience the glory of God. It's four times in the word of the Lord, it says, the whole earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord. But you know, when Moses was praying to see God's glory, and he saw the Lord, a glimpse of it from the Lord's back, he said something, and when he spoke about it, he says, the earth is filled with his glory. And I believe that we are moving as a church from the knowledge of the glory of God to the manifestation where we can declare that the whole earth is filled with the glory of God. And I believe that's not just for South Africa, that is for Denmark, that's for Europe, that's for the UK, that's for the US. I believe that's for Russia and for Israel. I believe the Lord's going to manifest in a supernatural way upon the nations of the world. We will see a move of God coming out of the Arabic nations. We'll see a move of God coming from there right across the world as the Lord by His Spirit will raise up His people and He will move upon them with great power that the glory of the Lord will be seen upon the kingdom and body of Christ on you. You know, it says this about Paul when he was in Ephesus. When he was in Lystra, Paul was in Lystra, and he was there with, I can't remember who the brother now was, but you know, the people started to worship Paul and the brother that was with him. I believe this is in Acts 20. They started to worship them because of what they saw, the miracles that they did and what they saw. And they said, the gods have come to live among us. And they called the one Hermas and the one they called Zeus. And I believe Paul they called Hermas, and I believe they called Barnabas Zeus. If I remember it right, Lystra. It will take me a second. Please forgive me for taking the time to find it. But I want you to see this. We went from Antioch there with Barnabas. It's in Troas. I'll have to go look at it. I'm sorry, it just doesn't come to mind. It's just too fast. I'll have to look at it. But you know, they thought that Paul was the god Hermas and that Barnabas was the god Zeus because of Paul's eloquency, but also because of the signs and wonders they saw in their lives. And I don't, you know, the world look at the, there's no, we look at all these movies, the world looks at all the movies, the Marvel, that's it, the Marvel Heroes movies, and they see all these heroes and so on. But I believe that that's also, God speaks through everything, and he's also speaking to the world to prepare for a great manifestation of the body of Jesus Christ in fullness. And that's my and your calling. You see, we are not just called to live as Christians and to actually just persevere and make this life and go to heaven. We are called to be carriers of the kingdom and glory of God. 2 Corinthians 3:18 says, we all reflect the Lord's glory. You see, you are called to reflect glory. You are called to carry that glory of God. You're called to carry the Lord Jesus Christ, the mighty presence of the Holy Spirit, to a lost and dying world. And I believe that the Lord Jesus is not standing in heaven now worrying about the church. He says, I built my church at the gates of hell, and hell shall not prevail against it. And that's what one translation literally says. So I believe that you and I are called for this. And let's prepare our hearts to be carriers of the glory of God into our cities, into our community, into our towns, into our workplaces. As we go back to work, it won't just be business as normal. Everybody speaks about the new normal. Let the new normal be that the earth will be filled with the glory of God. That's the new normal I believe God longs for. And we don't want to have a new normal of Corona. I'm sorry, I have no faith in Corona. I have faith in Jesus Christ. I have no faith that I will get it. I have no faith that I will stay longer on leave because of it. I have no faith for it. I have faith that I, my life, my family, my home, my work, my church, my office staff, we will be filled with the glory of God and carry it into our community and change our community. That there will be encounters with Jesus like very few people have heard of or read of. You see, it's when people's lives are changed by the glory of God, when their lives are impacted by the Holy Spirit, that true change happens. It doesn't happen because of great teaching. Otherwise, you know, if teaching would have changed the world, Derek Prince and all these guys, they have so much great teaching. If the world would have been changed a long time ago. If great preaching would have done it, you know, I've listened to some preachers that I thought, oh Lord, that's awesome. Thank you, Judy. There it is, Acts chapter 12, verse 11 and 12. I believe that we are called to bear that in the earth today, and that we're preparing. I don't say it's the end of days yet. I don't believe that we are living in the final day, but I do believe that we carry God's glory for this purpose, that the greatest harvest is at hand. You know, there's a place in the Bible that Jesus says we can speed up his coming, and I will read that to you tomorrow. I'm not going to read it tonight. I don't want to run ahead, but you know, as we carry God's glory and the earth will be filled with it, the nations will be impacted by the presence of Jesus, that the world will be changed because of what the Holy Spirit does. I believe that also the gospel will be preached to the ends of the earth, and then the Lord will come. You see, God is calling us to be carriers of his glory so that the gospel can reach the ends of the earth, that the gospel will go into places, and it's not just some missionary somewhere that has to go. It's you and I carrying God's glory to our world, to our work, to our home, to our school every day. And as we step into that, get an expectation in your heart. The Holy Spirit is going to come upon you. It's going to come upon me. The Holy Spirit is going to shake us up. He's going to change the way you speak in tongues. He's going to change the way you pray. He's going to change the way you see. He's going to change the way you think. He will come and fill you. Peter saw himself in one way. He was not even the guy that could stand up and speak in front of anyone. But on the day of Pentecost, when the Spirit had come upon him, he stood up boldly and he preached the word of God, and 3,000 people were saved. 3,000 heard the message, that his life impacted the world. In an instance, when the Holy Spirit came upon him, everything for Peter changed. In that instance, God will change you. And you might say to yourself, well, I can't even speak. I can't blah, blah, blah. Whatever you say, you know what? That's not a problem. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you may say, well, I'm sick. You may say, well, I've got this problem. You may say, well, I've got that. Well, it's not a problem. When the Holy Spirit is poured out upon the earth and upon the church of Jesus, you see, God is looking for the church ready for him. God is looking for the people that's prepared for that. And as we prepare our hearts, even in this time, I believe the Lord is calling us to seek Him, seek His face, and He will pour out His Spirit. You see, the Holy Spirit has been promised. Yes, we have received it, but I believe there's an outpouring. We have received Him. We have received the Holy Spirit. We love the Holy Spirit. But there's an outpouring of God that empowers us to step into a new season. And this earth will be filled with the glory of God as the waters covers the sea. In Habakkuk it says, the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God as the oceans cover the sea. And I believe God wants to take us from knowing about it to knowing it personally, to experiencing it personally. And that's the call of God in these days as we prepare for Pentecost. The Holy Spirit will be poured out upon believers' lives. He will fill you up. He will fill your home. He will change your life. He will change the way you see and think. He will change the way you pray. He will change the way you walk. He will change the way you see sick people. He will change the way you see challenges and difficulties. And you will see God's hand manifesting in your life and in your family like never before. And so this afternoon, as we prepare for that, I want to say, let's prepare our hearts. Let's prepare our lives. And one of the ways to do that is to pray. One of the ways to do that is by intercession and praying. Lord, here am I, dealing with your heart, dealing with your life. You know, sometimes we need to deal with some attitudes in our hearts. Maybe deal with some sin that we've left unattended. Ach, you know, we know it's wrong, but ach, everybody does a little something wrong. Well, stop it. Stop it. The devil is lying to you. You're being lied to. Stop it. Everybody doesn't do a little wrong. You are doing it. Stop your nonsense. Repent, finish, stop. And maybe it's time to say no. Maybe it's time to say no to sin. And I believe that is what the Lord wants to say to you and to me. And let us prepare our lives. Let us prepare our hearts. We can get so stuck in the circumstances that we live that we forget we are not in this earth to try and live and make it and see tomorrow and in the end die. We are here for the glory of God. Our lives are to His glory. We are created to represent the image of Christ and Him to the world. You know, like Adam was created in the image of God. He was created to show the world the heart and the heart of God. The reality of who God was and is and forever will be. And so are you and I. We are created for the glory of God. You are where you are, in South Africa, in Denmark, in Europe, in Uganda, in Tanzania. You are there for purpose. You are in the city that you are for the purposes of God to manifest through your life. And I believe that we will see the Lord manifesting upon His people, that we will be carriers of the glory of God, that we will be carrying the mighty presence of the Lord in this next season as we step into this. And so as we prepare for Pentecost, let us prepare our hearts. The Pentecost is the season of harvest. It was the harvest celebration. That's where the origins of the festival is. It's from seasons of harvest and from bringing in the harvest. And I believe that God is preparing to bring in the greatest harvest. God is preparing. I just, while I'm speaking, I just see thousands and thousands, more than thousands, it's tens of thousands of men kneeling before the Lord, calling out to God. And I believe that the Lord is going to break change upon nations, and they're not South African men or American men. They're just men from all over. And I believe the Lord's going to pour out His Spirit on a mighty way. And many men and women are going to kneel out to the glory of God. And there are men that have been stuck in wrong ways in terms of their lives, in terms of their families. And God's going to change their families. And Father, we pray for that today. We pray, Lord, that You would in this time as we seek You. Your word says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst, for they shall be filled. Lord, we hunger and thirst for You. God, we desire You. Lord, we need and we pray that You will give a mighty outpouring of Your Spirit in our time, Lord. You've called us to be carriers of the glory of God. Not just a revival, Lord, but a mighty outpouring of Your Spirit that will shake our world, that will shake our nation, that will shake the nations of the earth, that the people will know and see the glory of the Lord that covers the earth like waters cover the sea, that the world may know that You live, God, that the world may know that Jesus is Lord, and they will see it. And even in the midst of all these circumstances around us, we can carry You. And I pray for everyone watching tonight, God, that as we seek you in our private times, in our homes, in our families, as we pray and seek you, Lord, that yes, your presence will be with us. Yes, Lord, there's that person you're watching tonight that's got that problem with the left eye, and that eye has really been very painful. It's almost lost focus. And I thank you for that left eye, that tonight, in Jesus' name, that eye is completely healed. That pain completely goes. I thank you, God, for that person that's got that stiff back. I release that back in Jesus' name. That stiffness, I bind you, Satan. You've almost incapacitated this person. In Jesus' name, be released. In Jesus' name. There's a person with a jawbone. It's I don't know if it's an infection or if it is it seems like the density of the bone is falling, it's really giving way, and it's causing constant infections in the jaw. I thank you, Father, in Jesus' name, that jawbone is healed. The bone density will be restored completely. Those teeth won't fall out, as the dentist said. Those teeth will stay. That smile will stay in Jesus' name. And we declare that tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we receive from you by faith. And say thank you, God, that our nation and the nations of the earth will be shaken by the glory of the Lord. And we will know and believe and experience, we will know and feel and experience and see your goodness as nations turn to you. As surely as we live and as you live, God, that is your purpose on the earth today, is to use us as vessels of honor and carriers of your glory. As the waters cover the sea, the earth will be filled with the glory of God. Thank you, Father. And this week we're going to be focusing on seeking the Lord. We're going to be focusing on praying for our nation, intercession for South Africa. Our nation needs the glory of God. We're a nation of lukewarm Christians. Not all lukewarm, no. Many Christians are not, but we're a nation of lukewarm Christians. Yes, the church needs to be revived, but our world needs an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. We need Him. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord, Holy Spirit. We need you. God bless you tonight, and have a wonderful meal with your family. And in your times of praying, pray for our nation, pray for the nations of the earth. 4.5 billion people are in lockdown. It's unprecedented across the world. It's never happened before. And I believe that this is a season where God, and amazing to me, many of the Western nations, the Christian nations, very few churches across the world can function. It's amazing to me. And I've been thinking a lot about this, and I feel that God says, I've called you apart, I've set you apart, so that I can fill you with my glory, that you can move out as you step out, that the world will change before you. It says the scripture in Isaiah that the trees of the fields will clap their hands as you go forth in joy. The nature around us will respond to the glory of God. God bless you. God bless your home. May you have favor and blessing in this week. May what you require need of God, and I know many people are seeking God concerning their work, may you find that God has provided already before you as He moves before you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, goodbye and have a good evening.